Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you for watching. Have I got a beauty for you today? I have bought what I think might be the highest mileage FN2 Civic Type R in the country, if not the world. It is a lot of miles. I'm not gonna give it away just yet. I'm gonna let you see this car. We'll drive it, we'll see just how much that mileage has affected this car. Is it still worth buying or not? Does it still drive the same? Would you buy one? But I'm not going to tell you to the end of this video. So I think we should just jump straight to it. We'll have a look at this car. We'll walk around and see what it is. I think we're going to need to give it a clean and then we'll get it out for a drive. And while we're looking at it, put in the comments just how many miles you think this car's got. So, we've got a good bit of foliage on here. Paint, I don't know if you can see in this, several shades of red. Headlights are pretty well hazed over. You didn't think I was gonna leave the normal number plate on there and give away the mileage, did you? Every single wheel is curbed. The calipers are looking worse for wear. The discs have got a pretty decent lip on there. We have got numerous scratches. I think a ladder might have crashed on this. It's got like lacquer peeling off, which you can see, almost like a mold effect on it. It's still got the markings on it from where we bought it from auction. Mold around the window or moss. It's pretty much the same story when we come to the back for brakes. Again, the back bumper's a bit of a different colour. Plenty of foliage. I mean, this corner is absolutely sublime when it comes to colour match. Let's say every wheel is damaged, but not, it's not horrendous, to be fair. And there are a few scuffs along this side. And yeah, I mean, for the mileage, when I tell you how much this is, I think this is pretty amazing, actually. There are, you know, some marks, but I've sold cars with half this mileage, a quarter of this mileage, that are in worse condition. When we get inside, lovely. We've obviously got, I think, a bit of a leak from the door seal on the left-hand side, which is why this seat is so tasty. And this one's not so bad, although we do have some mold on the steering wheel. But these FN2 Type Rs, they're so cheap now and they are such a cool car. I think the design inside is still really modern looking. And the design on the outside is still really modern looking, but these bucket seats are incredible. I don't know how heavy they are. We're gonna find that out maybe when we get them out for valeting, but yummy. Romas, who is currently on a bit of media blasting out there, is going to have fun cleaning this. Well, here we are, guys, in the high mileage Honda Civic Type R FN2, and we're about to find out whether this high mileage really affects how this car drives and whether I think it's still worth buying one of these cars with high mileage on. I do have a bit of a confession to make. This isn't exactly a car that I've just bought. I do know this car, and I have in fact taken it for a track day because I thought it would probably die on that track day, and it didn't. It surprised me, and actually really impressed me. So I kind of know exactly what to expect from this car, and I know there are a few issues that might give away its mileage and age, but they are general kind of maintenance things, really. Things that are pretty easily rectifiable, and perhaps we will rectify those. But considering this is a car that I bought for £1,200 from an auction, there are fees on top of that, so I think it came to about £1,400 all in for a Civic Type R, 200 horsepower. I'm amazed, considering the mileage, which I will tell you, at how well this thing drives. And as soon as I can get out from behind the slowest Hyundai Tucson I've ever seen in my life, we will try and experience exactly how well this thing still drives. I've never been behind a car so slow in these lanes. So I guess what a perfect opportunity to tell you that the few things... Okay, they're pulling over for us. A few things, battery is flat. The clutch has very little movement in it. It feels like you've got about 1 inch of travel at the bottom, like almost like the slave cylinder's gone, but I think it's just the clutch plate itself has worn out. So ideally needs a new clutch. And other than that, what was the other thing? Oh, the brakes aren't the best, but I think probably the cheap pads that I put in got cooked on the track day, so I can't really blame it for that. Also easily fixed. Most importantly, I guess, is does it still hit VTEC and do all the Honda things it should do? Does it still handle well? Well, the perfect opportunity to find out now that we've... Yes! I love a Type R VTEC, and they are the perfect thing for these lanes. Yeah, brakes, that's hard down and still not really doing much, but that's not really the car's fault, that's more my fault. More importantly, this engine, I don't think you can really kill one of these engines. I just love the change of tone when you do hit VTEC. And those, I mean, I'm not a mechanic. The valves open, the changing of the valves opens up, and you get that extra boost of power up at the top. This thing's like an angry hornet. It just, especially on a track, if you're chasing someone down, and even if they're in turbo and they're getting all their power at 2,000, and you're up behind them, your foot flat to the floor, and it's coming 6,000 now, and it's screaming, "Get out my way!" In fact, I think maybe because I'm confident and comfortable with this car, I recently did a video with a 370Z, which has got much more power than this, but I am going probably a lot quicker in this, maybe because it's lanes and that's what, you know, suits this car best. It's these tight sort of corners and squirting your power out. But I think this is probably why I love hot hatches. You actually get to really make the most of the power you've got, the grip that you've got, really wring its neck and get it to do what you don't, and you feel like you really are racing. Well, I think we got fourth there, which was disappointing. I have actually just come this way in the opposite direction, and I happen to know there is a horse and cart somewhere along here, so I don't really want to go flying past full VTEC mode and cause an accident here. But on the whole, handling wise, it still handles amazing. Of course, it's not all original components. It's like every car, it's had some parts changed, but it doesn't feel really worn out. It's got budget tires on it, but it still handles incredibly well. The brakes, yeah, I know they are good, but the pads, I think, have glazed over from where I've cooked them on a track day, so we can soon rectify that. These bucket seats are incredible. They really hug you. All right, they probably hug me a bit better than they did the last time I used it because of all the extra weight that's gone on, but you are in here, you are planted. You know, if you, you know, I'm almost let slip what my plan might be for this car. To make it into a track day car, in which case I was thinking, well, great, we can get some bucket seats in here. But actually, I don't think you need to change the seats you've got here. You've probably got as much grip as you want for a sort of friendly track day. The steering wheel, again, you might be able to get something lighter and smaller, but it's kind of ergonomic. It's chunky enough, it's grippy enough that I don't think you really need to change that. And I think my plan is we are gonna make this our full-time track day car. And maybe even offer some customers the chance to win, come and do a track day with us, or YouTube viewers if we've got any. But in the meantime, we'll get this sign written up with some livery and our name and everything, and get the garage name out there, all while it's still a fairly modern car with air conditioning and cruise control, and this will be something that we can use daily and perhaps running to and from collecting MOTs. It doesn't have to be completely hardcore. It's I think the sort of, almost for me, like the perfect track day car. I'm taking all the members of staff from work and perhaps a customer. It's not so powerful that you can't go out and enjoy it and have fun. But it's certainly not slow either, and it feels exciting. So that is our plan. So in fact, I have got a stack of parts sat in the garage where we are pulling up now, ready to go on this car. And that is happening in about 3 days' time. New clutch, new brakes, new springs, all new tires all round. We're gonna refurbish the wheels, probably in championship white, which is like the Honda white colour. We've got an induction kit. We'll probably make some exhaust modifications, and then we will get it off to our sign writers and wrappers, quick sign, and get some livery on there. So 100%, I think it's worth moving microphone here, worth a like and follow, subscribe even for YouTube, to see what we're going to do with this car. But more important than any of that is what actually is the mileage of the car. I think earlier in the video I asked you to guess, give your best guess. Let's see who was closest. There we have it, 214,241 miles. There she is. Now, she may be a bit old and ropey, but I don't think it looks 250,000 miles ropey. Let me know what you think. Would you buy this car on that mileage for £1,400? Frankly, if I could get hold of 10 of them, I would buy them, and I would start Somerset's fastest taxi service, because I think this car will probably go on and do another 250,000 miles. So there we have it. High mileage Honda Civic FN2. Still drives like an absolute champion. I absolutely love this car. I don't think I have no reason to sell it. Frankly, who's going to want to buy it other than me? So definitely worth like and subscribe, as I've probably said already. Follow us to see what we're going to get done with this car.